panchayati raj institutions, they are, it is a system of the local self-government practiced very well and working efficiently at all the levels. Now, this panchayati raj system, three-tier system. The first level is of two sets, that is at the village level, it is of two sets, Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat. Next, you come to the second level, it is panchayati samitis at the block level. When you come to the third tier, it is Jilla Parishad at the top, district level. Now, what are the problems usually they will have? As I've already mentioned, they usually have electricity problem, water problem, proper sanitation, health problems. You know, you should have the primary health centers, and you will have street roads, transport, street light, all these. Usually, it's all mostly these are the problems which, if you go to the villages which are fertile, you will find that some farmers are facing a problems of, you know, proper seeds and fertilizers, proper, you know, good variety of seed. Sometimes even the panchayati raj system helps the farmers in solving their problem. It maintains the records of, you know, the land, also maintain the records of the births and deaths and all. These are the functions which take place at the local levels. Yes. Now, first we are going to first discuss about the panchayati raj system, its functioning at the village level, which is of two, Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat. Now, what is Gram Sabha? What is Gram? Gram means village. Gram Sabha, Sabha means it's a people. Now, all the village members, all the members of the village who are above 18 years, who are adults, they form the Gram Sabha. Now, look at this picture. You will see that all the members of the village are sitting down and discussing something with one head. Yes, with one person. Now, all these members are the members of that particular gram. That means these are the members of adult members who are above 18 years. They are all sitting together and they elect their president called Gram Pradhan. Okay. And they all sit together and discuss their problems with the president. Now, the problems, as I've already mentioned, are the main problems which they have in their local areas. It can differ from village to village. Now, this Gram Sabha meets twice a year. Okay, it sometimes happens that some of them don't even participate in the Gram Sabha, they don't have time or they're not interested, but they are the one who are going to lose. Sometimes it's some people participate, because if you are continuously being an active participant in that, you will come to know what exactly happened. Suddenly, if you go and sit in the Gram Sabha once in a year or once in 2 years, you will not know what is happening. And this Gram Sabha, usually they meet to discuss many things about their problems, especially the income and expenditure they are going to have throughout the year, and how much it has to be spent and all. Not only that, the main thing in the villages you will find is the tax. So they will discuss about the taxes, how are the taxes being levied, and what it is, how much it is, what is the percentage, are they being benefited or how far are they at a loss. So these all this is discussed, and with the Gram Pradhan, their president, they tell them, tell him their problems. This is the functions of Gram Sabha. Now, next we move on to Gram Panchayat. Now, all the members of these Gram Sabha elect the members of the Gram Panchayat. That means those who are 18 years or above have the right to vote for the members of the Gram Panchayat, and those who are above 21 years have the right to contest as candidates to contest in the elections of the Gram Panchayat. Now, let's see how the Gram Panchayat works, from where does it get its money, what are the things it does, and how does it solve the people's problem.